Good afternoon, everyone. So our innovation is Bowman's topography in LASIK and cross-linking. Now, beginning on a lighter note, why I'm showing this picture is all the ladies would agree that a well-fitting dress can actually hide many flaws. So we need to dress smartly, but if we extrapolate this understanding into our the world of refractive surgery, then a simple question is that could the epithelium be masking the underlying stromal surface? And I'm sure looking at these many modes of epithelial healing, the answer is yes. But then the question is, are our current topographers capable of acquiring the stromal surface topography? Are they enabled enough? So we tried to see what topographers are available with us at hand, but the answer came out to be no. The fallacies of the current topographers are the Placido and the Scheimpflug. They cannot dissociate the epithelium. However, the OCT topographers can do that, but the resolution is not strong enough. So what was our innovation was? Now the current modalities which find or locate the stromal topography actually involve an invasive procedure of intraoperative epithelial debridement and then looking at the stromal surface, which has been published by Gatton and et al. Group. So we, what we did was we wanted to virtually de-epithelize, and which was a non-invasive method, and this has been already published by our group of how we do this, and this is an already a published work of the de-epithelizing. Now I'm going to actually look into the various applications of this in our field of refractive surgery and cross-linking. So this is what we do is we actually capture the images on the STOCT, and we did do the canny edge detection method. You can see the picture. There's the blue line demarcates the anterior surface, and the red line is the Bowman's. So in our attempt to virtually de-epithelize, we actually have to study the topography at the level of the red line. And then we look at the tangential axial curvature data and ray tracing analysis, and then we get the pentacam picture, what it gives us, and what is the Bowman's topography. So how does this work and what are the applications is what our innovation led us to is. So we all have these suspicious topographies. So let's look at this case example. What is the pentacam giving us? What is the ASOCT? Now, when we saw the Bowman's topography, it was actually a very regular surface, unlike to what the pentacam was providing us. Then post-LASIK regression, we all face this problem. But we have this thing of blaming ourselves always. It's something we did in the surgery, but that's not always the scenario. You can see that this patient had an ablation of approximately 6 diopters, and after 4 months post-op, the patient has got a refractive error again. Now, we wanted to look this with our modality that is it actually a case of regression? The answer was no. Actually, the Bowman's was showing us flattening. So how do we understand this is that, you know, the epithelium tries to mask every irregularity. It forms, it fills in all the craters, and they give us a pseudo picture of regression. Now this is how it is. Next is cross-linking outcomes. Now we still are more than 10 years down the line doing cross-linking, but we're still not really clear on what is an ideal cross-linking outcome. Because the epithelium has haze, epithelium is, after the cross-linking, it tries to fill out the craters, and we're not clear on what is the actual outcome. Well, Bowman's topography is the answer in this case. You can see that there is a 1.24 diopter flattening, whereas the pentacam shows us only 1 diopter. Well, this is just a beginning. As we go down, maybe we have more flattening, and you know, this is how it is. I'm just going to finish up. This is a picture. Was this patient came to us for refractive surgery, so we were not sure if this was progression. We did Bowman's topography that was clearly stable. So it was the epithelium that was the culprit. We were not sure, and in this mixed picture, we decided that PRK was the safest option, but to accompany with cross-linking or not, we collected the epithelium. We decided not to cross-link the patient and collected the epithelium, find out what is the picture. So we analyzed it for known ectatic risk factors like LOX levels and collagen, and we found that from our database which we have, this patient had relatively very normal levels. So Bowman's topography was as predictable as the molecular sciences. So where are we now is that we have the software with us. But we are in discussion with the companies, and we're also trying to develop a biomarker kit. I have this with me if anyone would like to know more about it. And combining the molecular aspect and the mathematics to actually better pre-plan our patients. So right now in the discussion phase, we're trying to develop a very easy plug-and-play in software and a kit which is handy in our workplaces and in our clinics. Well, this is just to sum up that our innovation adds that we have a very novel method of non-invasive method of looking at the stromal surface. And add on, we are also trying to look at the molecular part of it and forming a kit. So, thank you.